and gentlemen, well, and the people who are here, Finger 11! Music. Stick around. We're gonna come back and talk to Finger 11, so don't go anywhere. Nice job. Alrighty, hey! Welcome back. Alright, shut up! Can't even hear myself frickin' think. Alright, hey, that screaming's for you guys. Finger 11. Yes, now you can scream. Was that a performance already? Wow, good job. You know what I like about you guys is that when you stop moving your lips, the singing stops, unlike a lot of pop stars.
That's cool.
So, you know, with a lot of the music today going softer, you guys are going harder. You guys sort of deliberately going in another direction?
Actually, we have no idea. We have some soft stuff, some heavy stuff. We actually just came out of the studio. We did something that was started off really, really soft, so
right.
Maybe we're just going with the trends. We're just turning into softies.
No, no, you know what? You're not going with the trends, because that was real music, as opposed to the crap they play all the time. He's doing a good job.
Yeah. Thank you.
Now,
it's here for real music.
Yeah, how about that? By the way, James, that's the equivalent of a, hello, Toronto! Let's just try and get the crowd screaming, huh? Now, can you look at all the fans you got here? People cool. Piled up against the window. How does that make you feel?
Feels great. Took us a long time to get this many fans.
So you look scared. You look afraid. Are you okay?
We have security.
We'll get you out of here safely. Trust me. Don't worry about it.
I think the fact that we've been away for a long time, we haven't come back to Canada, and now that we're back, we didn't know there was so many people.
What, living in Canada? You forgot?
They liked real music, I guess.
You were down in the U.S. You started thinking like them, that we're all living in igloos? Is that what happened?
Yeah, we got assimilated quickly.
Now, so you guys, you want to vent about your record company problems?
No, everything is fine.
Everything's good now?
Fine now.
Because now you got another label. You're really kicking ass.
Yeah.
You're in fine, fine form. Is that the best revenge?
Yeah, I think so. I think the people at home that were on our old label are probably regretting letting us go right now. And if you're not...
Yeah, you damn well should be, you
exactly.
stupid weasel.
I sort of ran out of steam there. I'm sorry.
All right. Now, we've got some fans here with questions. Do you want to talk to them, or should we just forget about it?
Yeah.
Well, no time for a vote. Too late. Okay, we got this guy with a mic. What's your name?
Chris.
All right, Chris.
He's from Flatline.
Sweet.
From where?
Flatline, the band.
Oh, well, what was I thinking?
I got a band question.
The hell was that, Flatline?
I got a band question. Hold on.
Linchpin's also good.
Shut up. Okay, what's some advice that you could give to some young Canadian bands trying to make it?
Oh, man.
Do you want the competition? Do you want to give them any advice? Just give them lousy advice.
I think the coolest thing is to just keep doing it without any intentions of anything blowing up or being successful, just doing it because it's cool to do and there's nothing better to do, you know?
Well, you stick with people you can work with, too. Because if not, you know, it's 9 years of this. No, I'm just kidding. It's a chill.
Finding band members that are as willing as you are to sacrifice and stuff, that's
the
hardest part.
Yeah. I mean,
No,
I was just going to say something. Is that cool?
No fisticuffs.
The longer you can, stave real life off, you know, and the longer you can just stay a band and just stay focused, you know. And I sound like, it sounds like a sports interview. You know?
They're trying to get some
right
numbers
place.
Up on the board, you know.
We're all winners.
Trying to get the right time.
But, you know, you guys, your definition of success that I've read is a little more grounded. It's just having the money to keep doing what it is you love to do. You're not looking for the limos. You're not looking for... you know, somebody to fly an airplane just to pick you up your favorite coffee. I mean, we'd all like that, but it ain't gonna happen often. So, but you guys just like performing. You actually legitimately are musicians. How do you feel about bands that don't play their own instruments, don't write their own music? Are those guys really musicians? Are they really, what are they? Are they entertainers? What would you determine
they're dancers, I guess.
They're performers, I'd say, entertainers.
And yeah.
I mean, I think those kind of... entertainers have been around forever, so it's kind of weird to start dissing them now. But
have they ever been so bad as now, though?
Well,
is that the big question?
I guess that's a question, but I think some of those things get a bad rap. But there's nothing equivalent to actually writing and playing your own stuff and following it through to the final point, rather than, you know, picking it up after it's already written and just putting some dance moves on it, you know?
A little gel in your hair and off you go, right? Do you have something you want to add? Because I don't want there to be any more trouble. There was tension here earlier.
I'm good.
You're good? Okay. We have another question from the audience.
Hi.
All right, okay, young lady.
Hi.
What's your name?
I'm Nicole.
Okay, where are you from, Nicole?
I'm from Oshawa.
Oh, wow, you made a trek.
Yeah, we did.
Okay, sorry about the layoffs there at the car plants. Go ahead and ask your question.
Rick, you were saying that you guys haven't been in Canada for a while. I was just wondering what it means to you guys to come back to Canada and if the fans here are just as good as your ones everywhere else.
Oh, they're better, of course.
Yes. Come on. Yeah. Toronto rocks!
Well, yeah, most of you have been with us a lot longer, so, I mean, that's cool.
But if you're at home watching it on American Satellite, we didn't mean
that.
Yeah,
we can't wait to see you either.
That was another equivalent of the, hello, Toronto!
We got them all. But...
Yeah, you guys are down, Pat. Okay, another question from the audience.
Hello, my name is Marisha.
What?
Marisha.
Marisha?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead.
My question is, if a promoter were to come up to you and say, guys, we want you to pick two bands to go on tour with all over North America, and the two bands have to be one that you admire and the other that you want to support. Who would they be and why?
Support as in, you know, like just like who you want to see really get great. Ahead. I don't know, man.
Like, we each get two bands.
Yeah, we each get to pick two bands. I would pick.
What about Flatline? Apparently, there's a member here.
I would pick bands that are sort of in the same boat as us, that are just making cool, unique music that doesn't really fit on the radio, and that's why they're not exploding.
Okay,
so.
But any specifics?
I don't know, like Sunny Day Real Estate and At the Drive-In, those kind of like, they're sort of underground, but they're starting to blow up. They don't really need our help, though.
Okay.
So, I don't know.
What about bands that you admire?
I admire
both
really of
those. I can't bring Pink Floyd with us, so.
Well, you could on this tour.
Because we're so big.
But also, a band from our hometown, Slurpee Monday, would be cool to bring out on the road if they had the chance and the money to do it.
Yeah.
All right.
Thanks.
You have any more questions? You're freaking nosy. Ask one question. You ask a follow-up. You're in journalism. All right. But you guys find that it's difficult, the more successful you become, to resist the temptation to try to concentrate more on selling the records than on making stuff you're happy with creatively? Is there start to be a pull? I mean, when you're starting out, it's easy to be legitimate, but as the lure starts to get, as you're getting closer and closer to the big bucks and the big success and stuff, do you find there's a temptation to try to just make it something a little more mass appeal as opposed to the stuff you do, which is really, you know, it's legitimate music?
Well, I don't know what big bucks you're talking about.
I know, it's Canadian music. There's no bucks in this whole frickin' country in show business. Talk about the truth, man.
But we were lucky enough, the records that we made, we try to keep everybody out of it until, you know, we're happy with it. And, you know, if it goes through everybody's filter, then it's probably good music.
Yeah, we don't really...
We're arrogant enough to think that, so...
We don't really listen to anybody else. There's like the five of us, and that's the way it is, especially in the studio. We just
try and keep everybody out, lock the door, and just...
We're too stubborn,
and I don't know. I think the more popular you get, the more people outside the band try to influence you into making, you know, just push it over the edge with this radio hit and stuff like that. And
right.
We see it as the more popular you get, the more opportunities you get to go into uncharted ground, and more people will hear it. You know.
All right. Now, you guys were on tour with Creed and Seven Dust. Now, Creed and Limp Bizkit have a little feud there. If you were to put money on Scott or Fred Durst, who do you think would walk away from a bare knuckles brawl?
I think I'd have to go with Stapp just because he put the challenge up and Fred turned it down. But I have never
met Fred. I don't know how big he is.
Oh, well, it depends how you mean that. I hear not very.
This coming from a sock. That's rough, Fred.
Yeah. All right. Now, you guys are going to be touring all over Canada, and you're going to be posting the diary on our website, right?
Yeah.
Who's going to be writing that? Taking turns?
Probably. Whoever's got the wittiest and coolest things to say.
So you're going to draw lots?
Maybe.
Yeah.
I might get down to that.
Is this gonna be like legitimately what's happening, or have you guys written the diary already?
No, just post it as it goes on. We're just gonna go and see if something exciting happens somewhere we're writing about.
Right.
Good.
Otherwise, make crap up.
Exactly.
Who's gonna know the difference, right? All right. So you're looking forward to that, the tour? And when it finally got to you, or are you just breaking down now? I knew I'd wear you down, man. Geez, either that or else you're losing oxygen in here because there's too many bodies and we don't have the windows open. But I want to thank you guys. You're legit.
Thanks.
You know, you come
thank
in here, you play good music. It almost helps me with having to play all that crap that I have to play all day long. I get to hear some legitimate stuff. What, you want to say something?
No, I agree with you.
You're giving me the cut sign there. What the hell matter with you?
No, I was
you
know? I was giving that too legit.
Oh, were you? Too legit to quit. Don't say that. Who was the last person that said that? It's Hammer Time.
I don't know. I couldn't even remember.
Yeah, well, there you go. Balloon Pants gonna make a big comeback. Okay, guys, I want to thank you very much for coming in, giving us the music, staying true to your vision, and for allowing the audience to come in here and press the flesh a bit. All right. Okay, well, we're gonna let security get these fellas out of here, and we're gonna go to a break. When we come back, we're gonna clear all these people out.
because and spray a lot of Lysol. Thanks very much. What? Oh, we're playing your video. You like this video?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, this one's good. This one's good.
Okay, here it is. You heard it from the horse's mouth. What? What was that? What did I miss here?
I don't know. Was that insulting? It's a good video.
Hey, the audience is making up their own jokes.
I totally.
Like Mad Libs. Okay. All right, let's roll the damn video. Things are getting way out of control. Thanks, guys.
Cheers.